It's Mindsight Chen, welcome back to another video of Minecraft Dungeons. This is probably going to be the last video you see of me playing a bit of Minecraft Dungeons for quite a while until the DLC releases. But today I'm going to be showing you the best hidden secrets and Easter eggs in Minecraft Dungeons that you may or may not know already. Continue any further, make sure to go and hit that like button, and if you are brand new to the channel, don't forget to go and click the subscribe button, hit that notification bell, getting all the latest info and up-to-date news with your boy HN. Go and get the secret obsidian chest. All you need to do is go past the house right here, and you've got to make sure you progress quite through the story, because if you do not have these piston bouncers right here, you won't be able to get to it. So once you've completed a part of the game right here, all you need to go is to go through here and then go right over here to the nether portal and then go through the nether portal, so you get past over here. Then all you need to do is go right behind here and go up these steps, so make sure you get up to this bit area right over here, and then just keep on going, and then you've got yourself an obsidian chest. So obviously, if you've already been here, the obsidian chest will either be opened or it won't be here whatsoever. But let's see what we get right here. So we've got some 105 sickles, and we've got some bows. And we have got some emeralds right here as well, which is absolutely amazing. It will be different every time, so it won't be the exact same thing I've got. But there you go, guys. Want a little secret obsidian chest? That is how you do it right there. But as always, guys, if you have enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button. Go subscribe if you are brand new to the channel. But as always, I love you so much, and I'll see you in the next one. This place where I want to go is this huge building right over here. Once you've progressed quite through the game, you'll be able to come around this area right here, pull down the drawbridge, and go into the chapel right here. Once you go in here, you may notice these paintings or portraits on the wall. These are actually the Minecraft Dungeons developers all on the wall here. Like, they literally fill every single bit of the wall, going all the way up to the top, and then all the way down here, which I thought was a pretty cool detail. I wasn't aware of it until I did a little bit of my own research into it, but as you see, we've got a few spaces here, but you've got every single different portrait of each Minecraft developer on these walls right here in the chapel. Next Easter egg is also in the chapel, right next to these developer portraits over here, and all you will have to do is go right up to this point where you'll see this little dirt block on the floor. Go to the left and you'll see this doggy portrait. I won't be able to do it right now, as I've already done this beforehand, so it will not let me change it again. But if you go up to this painting, press X, it will change from a doggy portrait to a Bion portrait, and it will be different every single time. So if you see a little glimmer like that, go up to it, press X or A, whatever console you're on, and try it yourself. This thing is also the secret rune level. As I said before I enter the chapel, once you basically get access to this, you'll be able to collect all these different runes in the main missions. Once you have, you'll be able to come into here, and there will be two obsidian chests left and the right over here, and in the middle there will be a scroll. Once you access that scroll, it will lead you to a mysterious island here where you fight a mysterious boss until you go and check it yourself. Cool little Easter egg is included in this house right over here, and if you aren't aware, or if you just got the game, or you have been playing the game for a while, this house is accessible. There isn't really much to it, or much that you can pretty much do in this place apart from just have a little look around. But as well, there is a cool little Easter egg. Once you defeat the redstone monstrosity in Fiery Forge, you will start to notice this blank bit on quartz and the mantelpiece of the fireplace. There will be the redstone monstrosity's head that will appear right over there. As well in the house, you will also notice a few little cool Easter eggs of a redstone golem portrait right there. You've got some creepers, and as well you've got a nice little cool creeper anatomy piece right there. There's a little bit of a statue right over there. Easter egg right here will only be available if you have Hero Edition, but if you do know what is included with the Hero Edition of Minecraft Dungeons, you will have immediate access to the free DLCs, and it will get you automatically as soon as they're released on July 3rd. You will also be able to go and get a few cool accessories as well. And these will be on cosmetics right here. So if you haven't had a little bit of an explore, go and basically click R1 right to the end and you will get your own hero cape and a baby chicken pet. So with this right here, you literally have your chicken that will follow you around everywhere that you go, and you'll have your very cool cape as well on the back. Cool detail as well is when you go and play high block halls before Obsidian Pinnacle, there is another cool Easter egg there that many of you might have not have noticed, but if you have noticed at the beginning where you go past the Arc Illage's statue riding a specific dragon, that is no specific dragon on its own. That itself is the Ender Dragon. This can also be shown on the big Great Hall doors of a dragon with purple eyes and scales and everything, basically picturing the Ender Dragon is the Arc Illage's pet. Another cool thing as well is once you go onto the mission select, many of us did not realize this at the beginning, but if you have realized this, good on you. But when you go to Obsidian Pinnacle right over here, you will notice the Arc Illage's castle right here, which is this huge area which you do as high block halls and Obsidian Pinnacle. But if you have a little bit of a closer look up here where I'm looking, you will also see the Arc Illager right on top, which is basically just a huge statue of him. But not least, also in the camp as well, you won't notice it at the beginning, but once you start progressing through the missions that you do through Default, Apocalypse, and Adventure, you will get emerald chests, which will include 50 emeralds in each chest that you get. And for example, one of them can appear here, but they can appear various around the map. So make sure to do go and check them out as well. And it is a cool little gift or progression present for when you do progress through the levels. Apart from that, guys, that literally sums up this video. I hope you have enjoyed, but as always, guys, let me know by hitting the like button. Go subscribe if you are brand new to the channel. And as always, I love you so much. Thank you so much for sticking around, watching my videos on Minecraft Dungeons. I've loved playing this game and letting you guys watch while I'm doing it. But as always, guys, I will see you in the next one, and expect some more Minecraft Dungeons videos around July 3rd when the DLC comes out. We'll be right back.